As I entered the classroom, all the students were looking at me. They were scanning me from head to toe. Everyone was curious to know who my dad was so they could measure my social value. They looked at my shoes, clothes, and bag. I knew they criticized every single detail in my physical appearance. I looked around and saw only famous brands. They all looked well-dressed and rich. It felt as if I was attending a fashion week in Milan. I knew right away that my $10 bag wouldn't fit in such a place. I knew I was going to be asked a lot of questions and treated differently. But before I continue, hit the like and subscribe button. If you do, you'll find a fortune hidden under your bed by tomorrow morning. Trust me, it works. Hi, my name is Karen, and I am the new student. I am looking forward to knowing you all, I said with a shivering tone, when a voice replied scoffingly out of nowhere. Yeah, if you survive till the next week. It was a male's voice, but I wasn't sure of the speaker's identity. I was too nervous and just pretended not to hear his comment. I went to my seat while hoping that this day would end without any drama. I know changing schools is terrifying. Almost all students worry about their first day because they want to fit in and they are afraid of being isolated. My case was totally different. I was not only afraid to be left alone or isolated, I was afraid of exposing my real identity. As I was taking some books out of my locker, a group of girls approached me and said, "What a nice bag," with a smirky smile on their faces. I knew right away that their intentions were to insult me because my bag looked old and cheap. Yet I replied, "Thanks," confidently, and walked away. After all, I guess the mysterious voice meant them when he said, "If you survive." Honestly, though I tried to act normal, I was horrified. I was sure if they discovered my real identity, they would make me suffer like hell. Therefore, I decided to be careful and avoid everyone as much as possible. You see, I am not only poor, I don't even have a house. I live with my mother in a small room dedicated to servants. And yes, my mom is a maid and the family she works for was kind enough to let me stay with my mother at their house. It was better than renting an apartment. Before that, we used to live in a small rusty apartment which we could barely afford. My father left us when I was a baby, and my mother took full responsibility. She used to prevent herself from eating just to buy me whatever I wanted. But when my mother applied to work for the family we live with, our life changed and things got better. My mother and I lived with that family for 5 years, and they were very kind to us. When I turned 15, they offered me a job helping my mother with some chores. In return, they paid me good money so that I could afford my expenses, since I was going to be in high school. I was super excited and grateful for their generosity, but what I didn't expect was when Mr. Let's call him X offered me something unexpected after saving his life. Once when Mr. X was having lunch at his office and I was cleaning it, he choked and I rushed to help him and saved his life. If it wasn't for me, he would be seriously harmed or even dead. After that incident, he offered to transfer me to a private school that only elites could afford. He said that I am a smart kid and should be properly educated. His niece Mia attends that school and we're good friends. She always tells me how great it is to be in such a good school, and if a person graduates from it, they won't find it hard to apply to any university they want. I hesitated at first, but I also thought about our lives. I mean, this great opportunity comes once in a lifetime, and it will open new doors for me. Therefore, I accepted the offer, and Mr. X assured me that he'd pay all the expenses. Now that I've told you my secret and how I got into such a great school, let me get back to the locker story. It just did not end there. After I said thanks and left, their leader, Kara, called me. "Hey, you. What's your name again, Carla?" "Karen," I replied. She walked towards me, asking in front of everyone, "Well, tell us about your family. What does your father do?" I felt my body shaking. I wasn't ready for such a question. I started sweating and looking around, trying to think of something to say. I was afraid to confess, but at the same time, I was also afraid to get caught telling lies. When suddenly I heard someone say, "He's a very successful businessman. He's super rich, but he spends his time abroad. And Karen likes to volunteer after school so she doesn't wear fancy clothes all the time. She's very considerate, you know." That's what Mia said while walking in our direction. That squad felt irritated by what Mia said and walked away. Mia immediately grabbed my hand and walked me outside. She apologized for lying, but she explained that if she didn't step in, those girls would eat me alive. She explained about the school system and how things work at this great school. She told me about the hierarchical triangle and what would happen if they felt that someone was different and didn't fit in with their social status. I was terrified. I mean, how could I survive in such a place? I burst into tears and wanted to just quit and get back to my old school. But I thought about my mother. Her words kept repeating themselves in my head. "I'm proud of you. You are the best daughter ever. I know you are going to be a great person in the future." These phrases pressured me to death, and I felt that my mother would be disappointed in me. So I just decided that I had to man up and fight for my future. Mia promised to help me as well. I was so relieved knowing that she'd be there for me. When I walked back to class, everyone was whispering. I knew they were talking about me. But what made things worse is when Toby approached me and asked in front of everyone to meet him outside. Toby is Kara's brother. He is a very good-looking guy and super attractive. I mean, most of the guys look good at this school, which made me wonder why almost all rich people are good-looking. I followed him like a puppy dog while wondering why he asked to talk to me privately. Why me? We stood in the hallway and he came closer to me. I felt like my heart was going to jump out of my chest at that moment. He whispered in my ear, "Wow, you're good at doing what people tell you to do. I know your little secret. I've been to Mr. X's house a couple of times, you know, and I saw you there." I froze. I didn't know what to say. I just felt like I was going to pee in my pants any minute, so I just ignored him and rushed to the bathroom before embarrassing myself even more. I closed the bathroom door and cried there. I didn't want anyone to see me. I didn't want to look like a weak person. Honestly, I was terrified. What does he mean by that? Is he going to take advantage of me now? What should I do? I called Mia immediately and told her what had happened. She was shocked. She told me that Toby is worse than his sister, and I should try and avoid him as much as possible. I went back to class feeling horrified, yet he wasn't there, which made me feel better. But when he entered the classroom, he kept on looking at me all the time. I was trying very hard to concentrate and avoid making any eye contact. The next day, Mia loaned me some of her stuff to look better. She thought it would distract people's attention when they realized that I was just a normal student like them. She was such a great person. She brought me the most beautiful bag I'd ever seen, some accessories, and wonderful designer shoes. And when I walked to school that day, I felt triumphant. People will finally leave me alone, I thought. But I was wrong. When I entered the classroom, I saw Kara standing there waiting for me. She said, "Hi, new student. Love the new look since you look good enough. And as Mia said, you have a great mansion. Why don't you invite us to your house? It's kind of a new student's ritual. Every new student has to throw a party and invite all of our classmates." I stood there speechless. I didn't know what to say. What should I do? I felt my heart racing and my body trembling. And what made things worse is when I saw Toby standing in the corner smirking. I took a deep breath and finally said, "Yes, I would love to. But meanwhile, we are moving to a bigger house. Once we're done moving, I'll invite all of you." I hoped the conversation would end with this sentence. However, it did not. Kara didn't buy my pathetic lie and said, "It's all right, we can come today after school just to hang out, and then you'll throw us another party once you move to your bigger house." And she was stressing the word bigger. I immediately knew what was going on. I was sure that Toby told her what happened yesterday and exposed my real identity. She wants to embarrass me in front of everyone. I was on the edge of collapsing when suddenly Toby said, "Hey, sis." And I thought about whether to pass out or run because I knew the moment Toby opened his mouth, my life was over. Yet surprisingly, he continued and said, "I don't feel like partying at her house today. I was thinking about throwing her a welcome party at our house." He walked towards me, put his arms on my shoulders, and winked at me. I immediately replied, "Yes, that would be great," while smiling anxiously. Kara's face turned red and everyone was shocked. I was shocked as well, yet desperate at the same time. But all I thought about back then was to get myself out of this mess in any possible way. During the lesson, all I thought about was Toby's reaction. I mean, why did he help me and stop his sister from embarrassing me? I glanced at him a couple of times, and every time I looked, I saw him glancing back at me. I felt a bit uncomfortable, yet I was blushing at the same time. He is so cute, and when he winked at me, my heart melted. I snapped back to reality when the teacher knocked on my desk, waking me up from my daydreaming, while telling me to wipe my drooling and pay attention. After class, I told Mia what happened, and she was shocked as well. However, she promised to help me and even suggested we go to the party together in her fancy car. However, she told me that what Toby did was unexpected and confusing. When Mia and I arrived at the party, I didn't expect what was going to happen that night. I didn't know that my life would turn upside down. When I thought Toby was trying to help me, I was wrong. Their evil genes are way too strong to have kindness in them. After a while, when almost all the school was there, Kara made an announcement and told everyone that she had a surprise for me. She invited me to the stage in front of everyone and called a maid to bring a special drink that was made especially for me. And when the maid approached me holding the drink, my heart stopped. It was my mom, that evil brat. She hired my mother to humiliate both of us. Mia was standing among the crowd and looked worried. She was surprised to see my mother there as well. I stared at my mother and I knew that she felt something was wrong, so she acted as if she didn't know me. I looked at Kara and saw the evilish look she had on her face. I knew that she planned for more. Kara walked towards my mother and poured her drink on her as if it was an accident. That's when I couldn't take it anymore and pushed Kara away. I helped my mother clean herself up and said in front of everyone, "This woman is my mother, and I won't let anyone treat her badly. She's a maid and I am proud. She dedicated her entire life to raising me and to giving me the best life ever. Having her as my mother is worth more than all of your fortune." I grabbed her arm and walked outside with her. While heading towards the door, I saw Toby walking in my direction. He tried to approach me, but I pushed him away and said, "I was stupid when I thought you made me different." Mia followed us and drove us home. My mother and I hugged each other and cried all night. She kept on apologizing, but I told her that I was embarrassed by what I had pretended to be rather than being myself. It's not her fault. She shouldn't feel bad. It's their parents' fault. They taught them to value money over humanity. That day made me stronger. I kept on attending the same school with my thrifty clothes and cheap bag. Weirdly, no one ever mentioned anything since that day, and Kara was avoiding me all the time. Mia was the only girl who spoke to me. Though I was neglected, no one else bothered me anymore, and I managed to focus on my studies. 7 years have passed since that day. I graduated with excellent grades and got a fully funded scholarship to a respectable university, and now I have a decent job. I'm proud of what I have accomplished, and I always aspire to become better. Though my job was very good, I applied for a better position at another company. After all, I don't want to be stuck at the same place all my life. When I went to the interview, I almost fainted when I saw Toby there. He was the CEO, and the company belonged to his parents. After the interview was done, I walked out of the room and brushed the idea of working there out of my head. I headed to the elevator when suddenly I felt someone poking me. It was Toby. He said, "Hi, long time no see. How've you been?" I replied with a cold tone, "Fine," and turned around as he shocked me by saying, "I'm sorry." I remained silent for a moment, took a deep breath, and turned to his direction, saying, "It took you 7 years to realize you've made a mistake? Well done." But what he said next made me speechless. He confessed that back then, he knew who I was and wanted to protect me from his sister. Though he didn't tell her that I was poor and my mother is a maid, she somehow knew. She had hired someone to spy on me and planned to embarrass me. But she did tell Toby because she was surprised when he helped me that day. After the party, they had a huge fight, and he hasn't spoken to her till this day. He also threatened her and anyone else who tried to hurt me at school. He was protecting me secretly the whole time. I asked him why he hadn't explained that when we were in school. He said, "I saw the look on your mother's face, and I felt disappointed in myself and disgraceful." "My mother? What is that supposed to mean?" I asked confusedly. And then he said that one time when he was at Mr. X's house, he met my mother for the first time. She was kind to him and helped him with something, and he was grateful. He asked Mr. X about her, and he told him our story. Ever since that day, each time he came to Mr. X's house, he would go and meet my mother. He loved her company, and she treated him with love and respect. He added, "She was the only one who treated me as a person, not a $100 bill. He also kept watching me from a distance. He said I looked like a younger version of her, and he felt butterflies in his stomach every time he saw me." I was shocked to hear his story. He apologized one more time and said, "I've lost you once, and I don't want to lose you again. So can you please give me another chance to show you the real me?" I grinned shyly and blushed. I replied with a cute voice, "Sure, why not?"